fat, too furious.
I'm too fast for y'all, man.
Too fat, too furious.
I'm too fast for y'all.
Oh, you just came home from doing a bid. Tell me what you gon' do.
Act a fool.
Somebody broke in and cleaned out your crib. Boy, what you gon' do?
Act a fool.
Just bought a new pair and they scuffed your shoes. Tell me what you gon' do.
Act a fool.
Now them cops trying to throw you in them county blues. Boy,
what you gon' do?
Act a fool.
Can't take what?
I love you.
love me?
I love you. And not in a friendly way. Although I think we're great friends. And not in a misplaced affection, puppy dog way. Although I'm sure that's what you'll call it. I love you. Very, very simple.
We'll be right back.
coming at you live in the desert. Welcome to AM1 action here on Contest of Speed. I'm your host, Electric Entree, joined once again by my co-commentator, Chubb Tucker. Chubb, how we feeling tonight?
Feeling good. How about you?
Man, it's another day in paradise. Looking forward to having a little better weather than we experienced last week in Australia. And ready to get this race kicked off.
100%, yeah, and we've got a fun one here tonight with Jeddah. I mean, a lot of high-speed action. Hopefully not that many safety cars. Now, I mean, this is AM1 after all. You know, we typically don't have as many in that division, but for all the other divisions, there has been quite a few.
That's absolutely right. Interesting enough, Red Devil has left the session already. May try to get him back in. But as I was saying, yeah, it's been an interesting week so far. We're coming in, closing out this round two here. But it's actually, from what I've seen, AM3, we didn't have any safety cars. A lot of broken wings, but no safety cars were brought out. I'm interested to see how AM1 does tonight on that front. These guys are so competitive. They race hard, and sometimes that just makes contact unavoidable. Or maybe not even unavoidable, but it'll make it more likely to happen as they're jockeying for position around this track. But we're on board now with Mindset, Camden Bauer. He announced he was going to change his name back to Mindset, but I don't think the game has updated yet. So he's still Camden Bauer on your screens, but he is Mindset. He's on the first hot lap of the night. Obviously, the Purple Sector won as he comes around. But I'll be interested to see. By the way, speaking of lap times, Cosbets is live. Get your bets in, over under on pole position time. I believe it's a 127 and change is the over under, but I'm not looking at it, so I can't tell you for sure.
Yes, I believe that is correct. And that is live. Yes, I can confirm that. So
perfect. Purple Sector 2 for Mindset as well, as he set the first times in those sectors, and he's got that Ferrari rocking and rolling. I was speaking to him earlier before the race started, and he was kind of walking me through. He had a lot of bad luck last week at Albert Park. Took some beating and banging off the start, broke a wing. He was down in last. He showed good pace though. 127.9 to start for Mindset. But he showed great pace, once he got his car issue sorted. But he ended up, did two pits, hit the pit twice under that first safety car. And he says he's not really sure why he did that, but he did. So he ended up with four pit stops during that race. Had some questionable strategy calls, but he did pick up fastest lap. Didn't get a point for it as he ended up in 12th. But he stuck with it. And he said he's ready to come out tonight and have a lot better showing than what he did last week. These times are starting to roll in now. We've got a 127.9 for Mindset, 128 from Pot, 128.4 from Potty, and a 129.0 from SSR William. That's your top three. We're riding on board with Pucks F1, formerly No Pucks Given, as he comes through Sector 2, starting into Sector 3.
Yes, Owen G-Boone goes to the top there with a 127.666.
Well, he's no Red Devil, but he is devilishly fast, as evidenced by that time.
Yeah, say that three times too fast.
Well, that was a little bit of a tongue twister there. We're still getting warmed up. We had some lobby issues starting off, so we kicked off, a couple minutes late. Nothing major, but a lot going on. Haven't got my tongue warmed up yet. So that'll put Pucks in third with a 128.1. Five tenths behind pole. Not a bad opening lap for the Mercedes. And expect to see these times. They will be coming down as the track evolves, rubbers in. These guys set out more qualifying laps. But that's a solid start for Pucks. We'll jump on board here with B-Shells. Well, he's going to jump in the pit, so we'll jump off of B-Shells. Looks like is that a Haas coming around? He's coming in the pit as well. Looks like a Ferrari coming in the pit.
We've got an RB out there with Kiwi.
All right, let's jump on to Kiwi here.
Yeah, he's in the first sector. Looks like Yes. Yeah, he's going to the hairpin right there.
Oh, and he sets a purple sector one. So wow. That bodes well for him coming around there. You can see trick here that I found around this track with the new ERS system changes that the game loves to remind you every time you leave the pits and qualify. You have your standard standard or medium ERS, your hot lap ERS, and then obviously your overtake mode where you really burn your battery. But seems here I struggled with in my qualifying rounds in AM3 burning too much battery and using up all of my allotted battery deployment before the end of the qualified lap. Battery management is key here during this qualifying session. You see we're on board here with Kiwi. He's sitting right at that halfway point on his battery. He's starting to burn it now coming through this DRS section towards the finish line.
Yeah. Ooh.
And that'll put him up into sixth place.
Yeah. Kind of fell off as the lap went, but kind of like what you talked about though with that ERS. If you don't manage it well, it really will hurt your speed.
Yes. Yes. Because yeah, like I said, I used up all of my deployment. I think I wasn't even midway through sector three when I used up all my deployment. So that last ERS, well, the second to last ERS zone, and then the last one, I didn't have any battery help assist at all. And my lap time, well, I say plummeted, but like it became slower there in the very last sector. So I had to be more cognizant of my battery usage for the next push lap. And so it wasn't as fast in sectors one and two, but I had enough to get through sector three and, you know, improve on my time. Red Devil going P2 with a 127.885. That puts him 0.22 seconds behind G-Boon. And he'll be looking for that top spot. He's in the hunt, but it wasn't enough to unseat the McLaren. And if you'll recall from last week, G-Boon and Red Devil, they had a heck of a battle for P1 in Australia. G-Boon, he had a hard send in turn 11 on the last lap trying to take that P1 from Red Devil. But Red Devil was able to fend him off. And I expect we're going to see some more fireworks between these two drivers tonight as G-Boon looks to avenge that narrow miss on P1.
Yeah, I think the top four drivers there, I mean, with Pucks, Mindset, I mean, you're, well, Camden Bauer, but Red Devil and Boone, I mean, it's really going to be a tight fight tonight.
Oh, absolutely. And they've got the opening race under their belts. They've kind of got an idea now of how, which, I mean, a lot of these guys are returning veterans. You know, they've raced together quite a bit. But, you know, with the new game, the new handling system, you know, I know they've run a bunch of five lappers together before the season even started, before preseason even started. But getting that long run race in together, seeing how these guys fight, especially when points are on the line, you know, that, I think we're going to see a little bit better, a little bit cleaner racing maybe. But maybe harder racing as they you know, try to take advantage of maybe some deficiencies they've seen in the last outing.
Yeah, for sure.
So Jay Supreme, he just finished his first hot lap, the 131.6. That's going to put him down into 14th. He's the last of those who have set a lap time. But we've got the Alpine of Garwin in the V-Carb of B-Schulz. They're out on hot laps now. So let's see. Garwin about to cross the line here. He will jump Jay Supreme with a 131.5. So that's just a tenth faster. 1.102 seconds faster. That'll move him up into 15th. And B-Schulz coming in, that'll put him P10 with a 129.1. So B-Schulz showing a little bit more pace. And I'll be interested to see B-Schulz, how him and his teammate, actually he's riding by himself tonight, so I take that back. I'm looking for, oh no, he's not. Kiwi's with him. Sorry.
Yeah,
B-Schulz
right.
And Kiwi, they kind of had a rough race last out, so I'm looking to see them bounce back. Maybe you know, I think Kiwi scored a P8 in Australia, or P9 in Australia. B-Schulz finishing P11, so you know they're gonna look to come back, put better points on the board this time out. They definitely got their work cut out for them though. This is a stacked field in AM1, and you know it's not going to be easy for these guys to get up there into those points paying positions and get some better finishes.
Right. No, I agree with that. It's tough to crack up into the top half of this division, especially, but you know, especially with those top four, I mean, They're really fast, but Potty is up there right now in third in the McLaren. So, you know, he's another one that really can help. He can help his pace, you know, if he just keeps it clean.
Yeah. Yeah, he had that unfortunate wreck. He was leading the race. I think he led 6 laps in Australia last week. He was in P1. I think he was trying to fight off Red Devil, maybe just hit the throttle a little too hard, trying to get a good exit, stay ahead of that Mercedes. And he wrecked it out, brought out the first safety car of the evening. He went from P1 to DNF in the blink of an eye. But he showed a lot more pace, a lot more racecraft, you know, than we saw from him last season. So I'll be excited to see, you know, where he ends up tonight. You know, I'm sure that's been stuck in his mind all week, and he's ready to avenge himself. We've got drivers dropping left and right here. Schultz has now left the session, while Emerson has joined. It's like a revolving door of AM1 drivers. I'm not sure we're having connection issues or what, but I'm sure they're keeping you on your toes, sending out these invites.
They are. We've got Emerson that just joined and came in the session. Alphanesis is still trying to get in here, and then also B. Schultz is trying to get him back in here with us. So,
well, and I'll do my best to keep an eye on it as you're taking care of that.
Yeah.
Oh, Cameron
and
Bauer.
Cameron Bauer.
He's gone now too. As I said, we're riding on board now with Kiwi. He's currently in P10. He's down 7/10 through sector 2. Definitely on to make a great improvement here on this hot lap. He's not really burning any battery now, but he's got the DRS open. He's flying 200 miles an hour coming down this straight into the final corner. Very smooth. It's just a little bit of oversteer from throttle application. Now he's burning that battery to the line, making a mad dash for it. He's going to lose that 7/10 off his time. It'll be a 1:28.2. Move him up into P7 from P10. And that'll put him ahead of his teammate Bischoff, who's dropped down into P12. But, you know, looking here at the times, you know, the field's starting to tighten up. You know, 1:27.666 for G Boone. And the top 5 all in the 1:27s. And then you've got the gap from 5 to 6 is the same as the gap from 1 to 5. But
right.
You know. But then, you know, you look there in 6 through 9, they're only separated by less than 7/10 of a second. And well, really 7 through 11. You know, I mean, it's so tight here. You definitely have to be on your A game here in AM1. But this is a fast track. There's plenty of opportunities in some of these corners. There's some runoff that will allow for track limits, penalties. Very tight walls right on the edge of the track limits in other places, and that presents opportunity for car damage or retirements. You definitely have to pay attention around here. G-Boone and right. Alphanesis both have left the session.
Yes, and I believe we're going to be having a reset here, so a lot of this might be for naught. That seems to be the conversation that is taking place right now, at least.
Fair enough. So we'll keep an eye on that, see how that develops out. Currently have Alphanesis and Emerson, who have yet to set a time. Everyone else has at least set some kind of preliminary time, with 3 minutes left in the qualifying session. As Kiwi jumps into the pits, we've got Pucks and Red Devil both on push laps, and looks like they're chasing each other around. Pucks has managed to bring it ahead of Red Devil, just barely, with he's 9/100 of a second ahead of his teammate there. Looks like they're both going to jump in the pits. As we mentioned last week, Devil, he got the P1. And Pucks ended up, I think, P7. You know, a little bit down the order. Still a double points finish for Mercedes, and enough to keep them on top in the Constructors' Championship, thanks to Potty's retirement. G Boone's kind of sitting alone with that 18 points from P2. Oh, and the lobby has lagged out. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we will be back momentarily once we get this lobby reset up. So I will cut the stream off for now, and we will be back very shortly.
you do?
I drive.
Like a limo drive?
Or like for movies?
Oh. You mean all the car chases and stuff?
Yeah.
Is that dangerous?
We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, I regret to inform you, the race tonight for AM1 here at Jeddah has been canceled. We will be rerunning this race at the end of the season, but due to technical difficulties with the EA servers, we are unable to keep drivers in the lobby. We've had quite a few lag outs just trying to get the lobby reset, and rather than have a cluster of a race where people are dropping in and out and nobody happy with the results because of things out of their control, we're just going to call it tonight and rerun this race later. Thank you for joining us tonight. From the bottom of our hearts, we apologize. Like you all, we were excited to get this underway and see some more of that great AM1 action that we're used to. But I believe this is the best call for everyone involved to get a true result. You know, you don't want to leave it up to the jankiness of EA servers. So with that being said, we are going to shut down the stream for tonight. We will be coming at you next week live from... Oh, I had the schedule pulled up here, and I just lost it. We will be coming at you next week
from Austria.
From Austria, thank you. Yes. Thank you. Coming in clutch there. From the Red Bull Ring in Austria, starting Tuesday night. Well, I guess really starting Tuesday afternoon for us on Eastern time, before p.m. Eastern. EU3 will be kicking off. AM3 will be kicking off 9 p.m. Eastern on Tuesday. And we'll be running Red Bull Ring next week. So, with that being said, thank you for your patience with us. We're sorry we couldn't have a better result here. And until next time, I'm Electric Entree signing off with Chubb Tucker. Thank you and good night.